Have you ever found yourself wondering which version of the ClickUp mobile app you actually need? Maybe you searched in the Play Store or the App Store and you saw this logo and you saw this logo and you were wondering, wait, which one is it? Well, you are not alone. And in this video, I'm just gonna briefly go over what is the difference between these two apps and tell you which one you actually need to be productive on ClickUp as a mobile first user. Before we dive in, I'll just remind you that there are timestamps for this video for you to skip ahead. And my name's Layla and I'm a ClickUp consultant. So if you have questions about what we're talking about here, those comments are open to you and I'd love to see you post your question in there. All right, so with that, let's dive into the mobile apps. The first mobile app I wanna feature is this one. And this is what we're gonna call the old mobile app. You can tell it's the older app by the color of the icon, but that's really the only tell you have when it's actually installed. This old mobile app was effectively the exact same thing as visiting ClickUp on your phone, on a web browser, okay? So it's really slow, it feels really cluttered, it's kind of hard to find what you need, and that's what the older mobile app was. But come February 2021, this new app was released, and this was really exciting because the older app had received a lot of pushback for being slow and buggy and no one wanted to use it. Ever since February 2021, anytime ClickUp is referring to the word mobile app, they are almost always referring to this new app. This is where all new features are being released and where all effort, from what I can tell, is being focused on. Ooh, and just to save you time, we have put the link to each of these free apps below in the description in case it saves you time to get these installed onto your phone. So given that, why the heck are both of these apps still in existence? Why do we have these two versions? Well, unfortunately, it's because in February 2021, when the new mobile app was released, it was released incomplete. And this is something that ClickUp kind of tends to do with new things. They want to put something out there and get better over time, which is fine. However, we are over a year later here and we still have an incomplete new mobile app and a complete but really slow old app. And just briefly, I'll walk you through what I mean by incomplete. First up, we have tasks, the ability to create tasks, manage tasks, and do all the things you need to do in order to create tasks on ClickUp. Well, comparing the features that you normally have on normal ClickUp, meaning on your computer, the older app has pretty much every feature you could imagine. But the new app still doesn't have features like recurring due dates that you can set on that mobile app or the use of relationships. So while tasks exist on that new mobile app and they're nice and flashy and all that stuff, you can't do everything that you would be able to do on a computer or even on the old sluggish mobile app. Moving on to favorites and tray, these are identical in both apps, which makes it really easy to navigate around. The only exception here is if you are favoriting things that do not exist in the mobile app, which I'll tell you about in just a second. After that, we have notifications. Both of these apps allow you to manage your notifications on the go, and the new app is way slicker and faster and easier to manage. Next up, we have documents, and both of these apps allow you to manage your documents on the go, with the new app, again, being much nicer of an experience than the older one. After that, we have views, and here's where we start to see some differences again. In the older mobile app, you could do just about everything you could do on the web app, but in the new app, it is still incomplete, so certain views, such as Gantt view, do not exist on the new mobile app yet. So, you know how I said favorites? Yes, they have favorites for everything except for certain features. Well, if you have a favorite view that is a Gantt view, it will not show up in this new mobile app because Gantt views are not supported in this new mobile app yet. Next up, we have the elusive feature of goals. And when it comes to these two mobile apps, there's a big difference in that the new app does not support goals at all, and the old app does. But I should say the old app, it's still not pretty, they just exist there. So difference on that piece as well. When it comes to things like settings for administrating your account, both apps have settings enabled, but you'll find in the new app, you will see a much simpler menu than what you're used to seeing on the older app or on the web app. So if you're looking to administrate your account, invite new people, change your settings, you're gonna find that new app just kind of locks you out and you have no option to adjust those things without going back to a computer or having the old app on your phone. Now, the last thing I'll say to really tilt the scales in the new app's favor is the quality of use. So the older app is slower and cluttered, as I've mentioned, and the new app, despite not having all the features that it does have, are very pleasant to use compared to the old app. And if you actually want to see a talk through of each component of the new app, feel free to watch this tour video. A few things have changed since then, but not too much. But the important thing to remember between these two apps is the old app is slow but complete, and the new app is very nice but incomplete. However, ClickUp is making a lot of strides in the right direction. That new app continues to be evolved. Even up to a few months ago, we didn't have things like dashboards or documents in the new app. Things have changed and evolved over time, and we expect ClickUp to continue to do that as they continue to pour efforts into this new mobile app. But eventualities does not help us today. So for the question all of you might be wondering, which app do we need? The answer right now is both. If you are someone who is a mobile first user, as stupid as it sounds, you will still need both ClickUp apps on your phone in order to fully use ClickUp. I know that's frustrating, but there are too many things that are still missing in that new app that I personally could not imagine being mobile first and only having the new app on my phone. There have been days where I have tried to be a mobile first ClickUp user to really know what that experience is going to be looking like. And every single time I try to use the mobile app, there's something throughout my day that I stumble upon that I need to go to the old app in order to manage. So if you are someone who's looking to be a mobile first user, get off your computer, go out into the field or whatever it is you're trying to do, I would install both apps on your phone, at least for now. Check back on this video and on ClickUp's release notes to see when the new mobile app actually becomes complete, but unfortunately, it is just not there yet. So that concludes this quick video. If you want more tips and tricks about ClickUp process and everything in between, please do take a moment to like and subscribe. And until next time, remember to enjoy the process.